Welcome to Bestia.dev. Learning Rust and WASM programming and having fun. I just love programming. This is my fifth video tutorial about programming in Rust. In this tutorial, I will show step by step how to create a simple web server with a database. I am using the Rust development environment inside a Docker container we created in the first two video tutorials. You can find them in my YouTube channel. Bestia Dev Tutorials for Rust Programming Language. Just type Bestia Dev in the YouTube search box. Today's project is a web page hit counter. I want to see the number of visitors to my web pages. There are many different options, but the simplest one is an old school web page hit counter. This is nothing more than an image on the page that is sourced from a web application. This web application can then count the hits and dynamically produce a picture with the number of hits. We are lucky that images, for now, don't have limitation for cross-domain or cross-origin. I will not really count unique visitors, because that is complicated. I will count simply every hit. This is a perfect simple example how to use a web server and a database in Rust. I choose the CrateActics web for my web server, because it looks very popular among Rustations. I don't know if other Rust web servers are better or worse. I need something really super simple and I don't want to complicate analyzing every existing web server crate. I choose PostgreSQL or Postgre as my preferred database because I have a long history with MS SQL and they look fairly similar. I also heard a lot of good opinions about Postgres. My Rust development environment is a podman pod with two containers. I will add to that pod a new container for the Postgres server and one with the pgAdmin management tool. I enhance the script Rust dev pod create sh from my project Docker Rust development. I created and started the new pod. A new port 9876 will be used for pgAdmin. I will now force the reboot of WSL to demonstrate how to restart the pod. In PowerShell run as administrator I use, get service LXS's manager, restart service. After reboot I need a small bash script to restart the pod, because of the peculiarities of WSL. Now we can open the pgAdmin management tool inside a browser on the address localhost 9876. For this tutorial we will not deep dive into database security. We will use just the admin user role. This is a big no-no in production. First create a new database named webpage hit counter. The first table will be a list of webpages with their unique integer ID. A table is made of columns and rows or synonymous of fields and records. The second table will have a foreign key to the webpage table and the number of hits. The serial data type automatically increases on every insert command and is therefore unique. I forgot to assign the primary key to the tables. We will add the foreign key to define the relation between the tables. And we will set the columns to not null. That is all for now about the Postgres database. The data will be inserted from the Rust code. We will create a template CLI project using cargo auto new CLI. Open VS Code. Press F1. Remote SSH connect to host. Enter passphrase. In the Rust projects directory, create a new template Rust project named webpage hit counter. Open it in a new VS Code window. Build it with cargo auto build and run it. Just to check that everything is okay. Eureka! It works. Let's begin our discovery of ActiX Web with a simple Hello World example. Classic getting started stuff. I will comment or delete the code I don't need and replace it with the code from the example. I use the VS Code extension, crates from Saray Uzger, to check the last version of the crate and quickly open the documentation. Let's rename the module and copy the code from the example. I like to leave some parts of the template code for future use. Functions that are used outside the module must be public. libRS has a big segment of doc comments. We can fold it quickly with the fold marker. We need to rename the module and allow use of all functions from it. The main function is copied into the bin main RS file. Now we copy the use statement. We can delete the unused objects. The bin main RS is a separate part of the project and we must write a use statement for the library project. In the Explorer side panel we can see in yellow the modules that have warning and in red the ones with errors. We can clean these problems easily. With F1 we got all the VS Code functions under our fingertips. I need to comment the code. Sometimes typing is faster than using the mouse. We can now build the project with Cargo Auto Build. In VS Code we have to open the port 8080, so that we can access the container from our browser. Run the compiled code without any parameters. Now open the browser on localhost port 8080. Hello world. It works. Let's try with another function. The routing for hey calls the function's manual hello and writes, hey there. We will now modify the code for our example. We need only one root named getImage. It will call the function with the same name. I like to use Rust raw string, because I can copy-paste literal text without modifying it. We will return a SVG file for the badge. SVG is simple XML text, nothing complicated. Let's build the project and open it in the browser. We need to add the MIME type so the browser can render the SVG instead of showing the text. We need a new dependency crate for MIME. There is need for a few modification to main and the automation tasks. Nothing big. We can now build the project and open the URL in the browser. Hooray! We can now see the SVG image for the badge with the word, hits, and the number 14. Pretty neat. Now we need to insert some data into the database. I will use the pgAdmin management tool. There is a graphical way to write data, but I will use SQL statements. Sooner or later we need to write SQL statements. And they are not so difficult. The basics is only 4 words. Select, update, insert and delete. In this table the ID will be a random number. Our first row or record is for testing purposes. Into the second table we don't need to define the ID because it is incremented automatically. The webpage id must create a relation with the record in the webpage table and for now we choose a sample hit count for example 3. We will find an example how to write Rust code to select data from the Postgres database. I choose the asynchronous Tokio client because it matches the Tokio runtime of Actix Web. This is a good moment to create a Git repository because we will experiment a little bit with the Postgres code. I use SSH agent and SSH add to store my credentials for GitHub. We add the Tokyo Postgres crate to cargo TOML. We create a new module for Postgres and a new function based on the example that read the hit count from the table. We have to add the new module to librs. In the Actix module, we call the function and print the result to the terminal. Okay, build it. Open it in the browser. It works. Check the terminal and we see the number 3 that was read from the table. Perfect. We want this number to show up in the SVG image. That is simple, because SVG is just an XML text. We will use the new format syntax from Rust Edition 2021. Works perfectly. Time for a git commit and push. Opening a connection to the database every time the server gets a request is not ideal. We need a connection pool to share the same connection for sequential requests efficiently. We can use the Deadpool crate. We will use the rust.env crate to keep database connection and configuration values in a config file with the name .env. We add also the dependency crate Deadpool Postgres. We will make a new module for Deadpool to have things neatly separated. First, we load the env variables. This is a special Deadpool Postgres crate and works with Postgres configuration objects. We add the new module to librs. Now we can call this function from the main function. Actix can seamlessly pass objects to functions if we use appdata. In this case, we pass the cloned pool object. I want to write when the server stops in the terminal. We can now add the pool parameter to our request handler and pass it to our database call. We need one client connection from the pool. This closure must be move. For debugging, I want to write to the terminal when the request is executed. Build and try. Refresh a few times. In the terminal, we can see multiple requests. It works. We will now introduce the parameter webpage ID, so we can count hits on many different pages. In pgAdmin, insert new records in webpage and in hit counter. The ID will be random 6x7 and the count 17 for now. We will use the query tool and write SQL statements. In this tutorial, we will not create a user interface to add web pages. That is reserved for my next tutorial. Actix has integrated tools to extract parameters from URL paths. It is easy. Just use the right syntax for the root. Accept the new parameter and then pass it to the Postgres function. Then pass this parameter to the SQL statement in the WHERE clause. Build and try with different parameters. The first returned 3 hits. The second returns 17 hits. Hooray! It works. The final step of the development is to increment the hit counter every time we got the request. We will write another simple SQL statement before selecting the value. Build, try, works. Done. We can create a simple example page how to use our webpage hit counter. It can be just a single page passive file index HTML. The show preview command for HTML is added by the live preview extension for VS Code. I use it because the VS Code server is running inside a Docker container. Marvelous. I like the graphic part too. In this tutorial, I will not go into details how to deploy it to my web server. Maybe in another tutorial. This is all for today. Thank you for watching and see you next time. Feel free to contact me on BestiaDev or GitHub.